Please excuse us. Patrick, I'm so sorry. I should have told you that Marty and Dylan might come.
I have a right to be here. No concern of mine. You look nice.
Thank you. You do too.
Excuse me.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
You all right?
I'm fine. I knew Patrick was back in town. I ran into him at the country club yesterday.
Yeah, so he told me. Yeah, he was in Rhodey's last night. He just wandered in.
You're kidding. Why didn't you say anything?
Why didn't you say anything to me?
I don't know. I guess I was just in shock. And I knew you'd be upset. I was. But I really don't think there's anything we can do. It seems like Blair's done such a number on Patrick, he felt like he had to come back here.
Oh, what, to help find Poseidon? Is that right? Well, that's not what he was doing last night. You know, him and Blair, they were sitting down sharing drinks.
They were both at Rhodey's?
Mm-hmm. Little table for two. Stayed there for quite a while. Then they left together.
Drew! So what do you think about your long-lost cousin?
Kevin Buchanan, ace reporter? I guess I'm a little envious. He's been to all these amazing places.
Right. Like a jail in Dublin. Very glamorous.
You were arrested?
I've heard this story, but he tells it well.
Thank you, Joe.
Vicky? Clint?
Kelsey?
I know this isn't the right time for a story conference, but could I pitch you guys an idea?
Please.
Someone's buying up waterfront property just as the mayor is passing zoning variances to allow it. Could there be a connection?
That's what we've been thinking.
In fact, we just told Kevin to check into it.
Oh, I'm sure if you want to help him dig, he'd be happy to share the byline with you.
No, thanks. I'd feel like I was butting in. It's Kevin's story. He should do it. Excuse me. Claire? Do you have a minute?
Have you seen the light?
Yeah, I guess I have. Vicky and Clint don't mean to be holding me back, but
as long as Kevin is at the banner, you won't go anywhere, right?
That's right. So, is the job at the Sun still open?
Yes, yes. I cannot tell you how much this means to me.
Well, I'm going to have to work out a timetable, I guess, and give Vicky and Clint notice, which isn't going to
be
easy.
Do it now, because you are now working for the Sun, and you're going to cover everything that happens at this party tonight, and you know what a bombshell it is going to be. So, what are you waiting around for? Get going, get going, get going.
Madam Mayor, what an honor that you could make it. It should prove to be a very, very exciting evening.
I have no doubt. Asa will be sorry that he missed it.
Well, Asa's not coming.
He had to work. You know how he is. I guess I better go powder my nose before I meet my public. I'm sure there'll be pictures.
I got some bad news for you. I just heard from Alex that Asa is not coming.
Oh, yes, he will. Just give it time.
Sir, this just arrived by messenger.
Asa, if you really want to know what's going on with your wife, come to the Palace restaurant now. A concerned friend.
Will there be a reply?
Late night dinners for two in the smoky cafes in Gay Paris.
Oh, you mean when I was having my torrid affair with Duke?
Mm.
No. Actually, he hated cafes. He thought they were bourgeois.
Oh.
He preferred a déjeuner sur herbe, which is a picnic on the grass.
Thank you.
He would be sipping his wine. He'd be fully clothed. And I'd be lying there like dessert.
I think I saw a painting of that one time.
Yeah.
Most of the girls at my convent school saw that same painting, so they never believed my stories about the Duke. Mm. Or the famous bullfighter, or the wounded aviator.
Did you just do nothing but daydream all day?
Well, you know, that was better than feeling sorry for myself. I didn't really have a lot of friends. And my mom was put away. And, you know, Aunt Dorian, she really only wrote once a month. Sometimes I'd get this feeling, you know, if nobody knows I'm here, do I exist?
Well, it's no wonder you started to tell stories.
Yeah, and Paris. Paris was the perfect background for all my romantic fantasies. But, I always had to come back to Earth eventually. Like now. Joey, it was so sweet of you to go through all of this trouble for me. But this isn't Paris. And we are on a roof in Landview, Pennsylvania. Why are you pretending?
Hey, wait a second. I'm not pretending that I love you.
But you think I can't handle the real world?
No. Kelly, no, I'm trying to show you that I think you have a wonderful imagination.
But I want to make the things I imagine real.
Well, maybe I can help.
RJ, thank God you are back. This woman has been calling.
Well, I hope you told her to wait in line.
I'm serious, RJ. I think it was Rachel.
Rachel? Well, did she say where she was?
She wouldn't even give me her name, but I didn't want her to get away, so I told her to call back here in 10 minutes.
Okay, good. Good. Thanks, Ronnie. Oh, God, I hope she's all right. Did she sound like she was in trouble?
She didn't sound anything, RJ, but if it was Rachel, don't you think you should contact her parents? I'm sorry to interrupt, but, Nora, Hank, somebody just called from Club Indigo, and they want you to get over there as soon as possible. Rachel just called there.
Nora, let's go.
No. I will tell Bo where you've gone.
Just go.
Look, sweetheart, I know you need to be here to represent the hospital, but you're welcome to come along if you like.
No, you better get on with it.
Thanks.
Good luck. Relax. Make a distinguished appearance. Asa, what are you doing here?
I'm wondering the same about you, Alex. What is this all about?
If you really want to know what's going on in the forthcoming palace restaurant, this is the bait for the trap, Asa. Don't you see that? You've got to get out of here right away.
Vicky, Flynn,
Cassie,
could I talk to you?
Another story idea?
No, that would be a lot easier. This is hard. I just feel that...
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please?
We'll talk later.
Excuse me. Quiet, please. In just a moment, I am going to make my announcement. I'm going to introduce our guest of honor, the friend to Landview.
It's time to pick up the phone and tell us what you're thinking about the latest in Landview. Call Soap Talk now at 1-900-740-5000. We'll give you a sneak preview, and you can give us your opinion. Call 1-900-740-5000.
95 cents per minute.
Tickets. To Paris?
Yeah. You and me for spring break. I already cleared it with Andrew and Cassie, so if you want to go, we're out of here tonight.
You mean tonight?
Yeah. Look, Kelly, I know you had a lot of romantic adventures in Paris, but they've all been in your head. I figured you deserved a shot at the real thing. Now, I'm no Duke. I know that, but if you want to go jumping in any fountains, I'm your guy.
Is this what you meant? When you said that you were going to make my first time special?
Well, Callie, why don't we just let whatever happens, happen? We'll plan on having a good time, and we'll just take it from there, okay? One thing that I do promise you is that I will try my hardest to make all your dreams come true. Even some that you didn't even know you had.
Rachel? Oh, thank God it's you. Look, honey, are you all right? Look, Rachel, what is it? What's wrong?
Why take a notes? I thought Kevin was covering this.
He is, for the banner. I'm working for the Sun now.
The Sun? You're joking, right? I thought you hated the Sun and everything it stands for.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your patience, but I hope that you'll agree with me and my paper, the Sun, that the wait was worth it. Now, the man that I'm about to introduce, you may think that you know by reputation, but I would like for you to keep an open mind and realize that people change. Like this man, who was no one's friend before, who has now become the friend to Landview.
What the hell,
Carl?
Ladies and gentlemen, friends, or at least I hope I will be able to call you friends soon. I apologize if I startle you. You aren't seeing things. I'm not a ghost. I am very much alive. And after a long, hard recovery, I am well. And glad to be back in Landview. As I look about this room, I recognize
everyone dies. No loose ends. Excellent.
I hope you
it's all the voice I
suspend
heard. That's him, Mr. Poseidon.
Until such time.
Ah, Isa! There you are.
Alexandra.
I'm Susan Betts O'Horgan. Please join us in celebrating Erika Slezak's 25th anniversary on One Life to Live. Here's to you, Erika.